In the Bhagavat Puran or Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a beautiful description of how Lord Shiva was attracted by the Mohini incarnation or Mohini Avatar of Lord Vishnu. Lord Shiva heard about the pastimes or the leelas of Mohini Avatar and desired to see the Mohini Avatar. So with this desire, Lord Shiva approached Lord Vishnu accompanied by his wife Uma and his servants, the ghosts. Lord Shiva reached the place of Lord Vishnu and offered obeisances to Lord Vishnu. He then offered lot of prayers glorifying Lord Vishnu. After that, Lord Shiva expressed his desire to see the beautiful Mohini Avatar of Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu smiled a little bit. But Lord Vishnu is very kind to his devotees. He fulfills the desire of his devotees. So Lord Vishnu, in order to fulfill the desire of Lord Shiva, he expanded his energy and manifested himself in the form of a very beautiful and attractive woman called the Mohini Avatar. At first, Lord Shiva could not see Mohini Avatar. Thereafter, after searching here and there, Lord Shiva saw a beautiful forest, which is full of beautiful trees and many beautiful flowers. And in that forest, Lord Shiva saw a beautiful woman playing with a ball. Her hips were covered with a shining sari and ornamented with a belt. Because the ball was falling down and bouncing up as she played with it, her breasts trembled, and because of the weight of those breasts and her heavy flower garlands, her waist appeared to be all but breaking at every step. And her two soft feet, which were reddish like coral, moved here and there. The woman's face was decorated by broad, beautiful, restless eyes, which moved as the ball bounced here and there from her hand. The two brilliant earrings on her ears decorated her shining cheeks like bluish reflections, and the hair scattered on her face made her even more beautiful to see. She played with the ball, the sari covering her body became loose, and her hair scattered. She tried to bind her hair with her beautiful left hand, and at the same time she played with the ball by striking it with her right hand. This was so attractive that the Supreme Lord, by his internal potency, captivated everyone in this way. While Lord Shiva observed the beautiful woman playing with the ball, he sometimes glanced at him and slightly smiled in bashfulness. As he looked at the beautiful woman and she watched him, he forgot both himself and Uma, his most beautiful wife, as well as his associates nearby. When the ball leaped from her hand and fell at a distance, the woman began to follow it. But Lord Shiva observed these activities, and suddenly a breeze blew away the fine dress and belt covering Mohini Avatar. Thus Lord Shiva saw the woman whose every part of his body, of her body was beautifully formed, and the beautiful woman also looked at him. Therefore, thinking that she was attracted to him, Lord Shiva became very much attracted to Mohini Avatar. Lord Shiva lost his good sense and was swayed away by the lusty desires of enjoying this beautiful woman. He became so mad for this beautiful woman, Mohini Avatar, that he forgot even the presence of his wife Bhaväni, Ma Durga. And in the presence of Ma Durga, Lord Shiva approached this beautiful woman, who is the Mohini Avatar. The beautiful woman was already naked, and when she saw Lord Shiva coming towards her, she became extremely bashful. She saw Lord Shiva coming towards her. She kept smiling, but she hid herself among the trees and did not stand in one place. Lord Shiva, his senses were agitated, and it was victimized by lusty desires. And Lord Shiva began to follow her, just as a lusty elephant follows a she-elephant. After following her with great speed, Lord Shiva caught her by the braid of her hair and dragged her near him. Although she was unwilling, Lord Shiva embraced her with his arms. Being embraced by Lord Shiva like a female elephant embraced by a male, the woman whose hair was scattered swirled like a snake. O king, this woman who has large high hips was a woman of Yogmaya presented by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. She released herself somehow or other from the fond embrace of Lord Shiva's arms and ran away. As if harassed by an enemy in the form of lusty desires, Lord Shiva followed the path of Lord Vishnu, Mohini Avatar, who acts very wonderfully and who had taken the form of this beautiful lady, Mohini. Just as a maddened bull elephant follows a female elephant who is able to conceive pregnancy, Lord Shiva followed the beautiful woman and discharged semen, even though his discharge of semen never goes in vain. O king, now wherever this semen of Lord Shiva fell on the earth, in those places gold mines and silver mines were littered, it was formed. So these gold mines and silver mines that you see in the earth are nothing but the manifestation of the semen of Lord Shiva. And Lord Shiva discharged semen while he was trying to find out Mohini Avatar. Following Mohini, Lord Shiva went everywhere, near the shores of the rivers, lakes, near the mountains, forests, gardens, and wherever there lived great sages. Lord Shiva then, in search of Mohini Avatar, he fully discharged semen. And upon fully discharging the semen, he came to his senses. And he could then see that Lord Shiva, he was bewildered by the illusory energy of Lord Krishna or Lord Vishnu. Thus, Lord Shiva then restrained himself from any further maya. Once one is agitated by lusty sexual desires upon seeing a woman, those sex desires increase more and more. But when semen is discharged in the act of sex, the lusty desires diminish. The same principle acted upon Lord Shiva. He was allured by the beautiful woman, Mohini Murti, But when his semen had been fully discharged, he came to his senses and realized how he had been victimized as soon as he saw the woman in the forest. So in this way, we saw how Srimad Bhagavatam describes that Lord Shiva was bewildered by the beautiful woman, Mohini Murti. Lord Shiva saw this beautiful woman in her naked form and was attracted towards her. In this way, lusty desires act, and these sex desires completely make a person mad. So, anyone who is desiring to go in the spiritual path should restrain himself from these lusty desires. And this is possible by simply chanting the holy names of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.